وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى I'm going to start a series where I will be speaking about the lost legacy of the female scholars of Islam. And inshallah ta'ala, before I go into the topic, there are a couple of points inshallah ta'ala that I want to bring to your attentions, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Important, vital points that I want you to all know. As you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created male and female. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can do whatever He wishes. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيرَةُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can choose whatever He wishes. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chose to create male and female. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the male human beings as much as He made the females human beings. The male is not more of a human being than the woman is a human being. They are the same, and there is no difference between both of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى Allah created two pairs, male and female. Allah created it subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also in another verse, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ O people, اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ Fear your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which Lord? الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ The one who created you. مِن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ From one nafs. وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا And from there Allah made pairs. He made male and female, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The male and the female, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created with His infinite knowledge, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and His infinite wisdom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chose to make legislations that are befitting to the men. And He has made legislations that are befitting to the women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Qur'an, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I did not create the jinn or the ins. And when we say ins here, we mean male and female. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He made a legislation for them, which is all of them need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that legislation is unique for each person in some ways. Umumul risala, the umumul deen, the general ruling of the religion is the same for the male and female. Qala ta'ala, Allah says, Man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha wa huwa mu'minun falanuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyiba. If a male or a female does a righteous action, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will reward them for it and He will give them a good life in this world. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ Whoever does righteous action, مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى Male or female, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ And the person is a believer, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ نَقِيرًا Allah will not oppress the male or the female for the good that they have done. Allah will not oppress them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ They will enter Jannah and Allah will not oppress them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from there, what do we learn? We learn that male and female, whatever righteous action they come with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them for it. لَا فَرْقَ بَيْنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ There is no difference between the male and the female في عموم الدين, in the general essence of the religion. يعني توحيد is required from the men and it's also required from the women. اعتقاد, the عقيدة is required from the men and it's also required from the women. حقائق الإيمان, the reality of إيمان أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خير وشر is required from the male and the female. Islam is required from male and female. The five pillars of Al-Islam, أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه السبيلة. All of that reply applies to the men and the female. The reward and the punishment. If a man does a righteous action and a woman does a righteous action, the reward for it, male and female, is the same. If a man commits zina and a woman commits zina, the punishment is the same for both of them. The virtuous actions that the men do and the virtuous actions that the women do is also the same. The obligatory acts that the men and the women do is also the same to Allah Ta'ala. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. The best from amongst us is the pious one, whether it be male or female. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, He says, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى بَعْضُكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْضٍ. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He tells us, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ. Allah obeyed for them their dua and their supplication. And Allah mentioned here, أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ, I do not forsake, عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ, the action of one of you, whether it be مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى, male or female. بَعْضُكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْضٍ, you are from one another. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He tells us that we're from one another. So all of this, what does it show us? It shows us that the male and the female are the same in being human beings. And they are also same in the general sense of the ahkam of the sharia. That being said, lakin, Islam has connected some rulings specific to men and some rulings specific to women, because we believe in our religion that men and the women are not the same. Even though they share being human beings, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He made differences for them, and they are not the same. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. The men are not the same as the women, and the women are not the same as the men. And I don't think, inshallah ta'ala, any sane individual will argue that. Since they're not the same, and Allah created some differences in them, Allah has made ahkam, rulings, some rulings unique for the men and some rulings unique for the women. Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah mentions here, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ, is the creating not from Allah? I mean, isn't Allah not the one who created? Allah is the one who created the men, and Allah is the one who created the women. Does He then not have the rights? أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. Does Allah not have the right of, since He's the one who created the men, and since He's the one who created the women, does He not have the right, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to command the men a specific ruling and to command the women a specific ruling? Allah then says, Tabarakallahu Rabbul Alameen. High is Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, we are not allowed to, and we are prohibited, since there are those differences that are between us, that which Allah specifically gave to the male, the women should not wish for it. And whatever is given to the women, the men should not wish for it. We should understand that these are differences Allah made, لِحِكْمَةٍ يَعْلَمُهَا, that He knows why He made this ruling for the women and this ruling for the men. He knows it. And we as human beings, since He created us and He has the choice, we should surrender and give in. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. If Allah and His Messenger have given a ruling in a matter, we have no choice after that. Also, Allah prohibited us specifically. He prohibited the men to not wish for what's been given to the women, and the women not to wish for what is being given to the men. Allah says, وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوْا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِي بَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ لِلرِّجَالِ نَصِيبٌ مِّمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا وَلِلنِّسَاءِ نَصِيبٌ مِّمَّا اكْتَسَبْنَ وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. Allah says, وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوْا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ. Do not hope for, wish for that which Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala virtued some of you over the other. Then Allah says, لِلْرِجَالِ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا. The men, they have things that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala virtued them for. وَلِلْنِسَاءِ نَصِيبٌ. And women have their portion that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has given to them. Then Allah says, وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِ. Ask Allah for the virtue. Ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala for it. Inna Allah kana bi kulli shay'in alima. Allah has infinite knowledge of everything. Allah has infinite knowledge of everything. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to mention a last point for this episode, inshallah ta'ala, and that is, if we look at the Islamic history, these points that I brought, and how Islam looks at men and women, civilization, Western civilizations, and other civilizations, things that they have never reached, Islam has already reached way before that. In Europe, women were not seen as human beings. Until recently, women were seen as something else. Even philosophy, yeah, Greek philosophy, like Socrates. Socrates has an ideology and a belief, or Aristotle, or is it Plato? I'm not sure which one it was. They had the belief that women are the evil side of men. This is what Western civilization used for the Renaissance and the Enlightenment. Nabi Muhammad and the Qur'an already mentioned that women are human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala virtued them. The ayah is clearly saying, وَلِلنِّسَاءِ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبْنَا. Women have their virtue and their position in Islam. Allah gave it to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ, the French, leading French polymath, Gustave Le Bon, he mentioned and he said that في تاريخ الإسلام, Islamic history, he mentioned that there were نوابغ من النساء, women that came out in Islamic history. And they were scholars في كافة الفنون والعلوم. They were scholars in different sciences and different subjects, يعني علماء. And he said, وتراجمهن, and their biography, حافلة, it's filled up in the books, it's there. And he mentioned some of them were jurists, يعني فقهاء. They were فقهيات. They were فقهيات. And they were مفسرات. And they were أدبيات and شاعرات and عالمات في سائر علوم الدين واللغة. This is a what? A leading French polymath whose areas of interest included anthropology, psychology, sociology, medicine, invention, and physics. He's well known for his, you know, work he wrote in 1895, The Crowd, A Study of the Popular Mind. He is saying that the Ahd al-Abbasi, the Abbasi time, there came out women in Andalus that were famous for knowledge. And then he said something very powerful. And he said, the reason for this is because من الأدلة على أهمية النساء أيام نضارة حضارة المسلمين. He mentions the reason why these type of women could come out and they could prosper and they could have learned all of that was because of the civilization of the Muslims. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.